Yes, DJ Wazzy back once again. Bringing you some mellow tunes for the next half an hour. We've got a bit of old school quieter with a bit of Afro beats for you. As we celebrate South Africa Youth Day together.
Going to take place. So in terms of the program, we've just had DJs who have been rotating between 5 o'clock for the last hour. They've been rotating, and then we have sung the national anthem. I hope that you have also sung the national anthem where you are. And we had a moment of silence for our fallen heroes and Black Lives Matter. And then we are going to have our welcome remarks soon. But in terms of the program, we are going to screen the film. We're going to screen the film Sarafina, and after screening the film, we are going to have a message from a message of support. After the message of support, we are going to play Mbongeni Ngema song, and then we are going to then ask our questions to Mbongeni Ngema, whatever questions you may have about the film. And I hope that he will also then use this opportunity to release a little secret. He's going to give us a teaser of a little secret, and then we are going to then you are all going to be able to ask the questions, as I've said. Then we'll have a poem from a young person. A young person is going to dedicate a poem to us. Then we have a PJ Powers song, and firstly we're going to see PJ singing with the late Sifiso Ncwane. We thought it's appropriate that we honor again one of our young people who've left us in the form of Sifiso Ncwane, but there is a song that we're going to see being performed by both of them. After that song, we already have PJ who has logged in. We will have PJ Powers, sharing her experiences of the life and the times in South Africa during her peak years. And she's still in peak form until today. She's a legend. In fact, today we are joined by two legends in the form of PJ Powers and Mbongeni Ngema. After those questions, we're going to have remarks from after the interaction with PJ Powers and Mbongeni Ngema, we're going to have remarks by someone from the diaspora, and then we have a remarks by a young person, and then we are going to open up the party, the DJing, which is going to last until 12 midnight in the UK and 1 a.m. in South Africa. And guess what song I've asked the DJs to play for you first? I know, okay. Kanagata will be second, but the first one is going to be Sister Bettina. Oh, stay tuned. And I just want to thank the DJs who have graced us today. DJ Mkukwini, Levi Love, DJ Wazzy, Golden Ladi, King T. And I must say, ladies and gentlemen, this has also been a brainchild of DJ Mkukwini. His real name is Ndumiso. He's really, really worked hard to make sure that today is a success. And now he's playing host, actually, even on the dials as well. So I just want us to acknowledge him and give him a big round of applause for the role that he has played. My name is Pumela Salela, and I am the country head for Brand South Africa in the United Kingdom. And it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure to have you here in numbers. We like you.
Our nation was searching for truth and freedom.
The schools are your only chance. If you don't want education, do not come to school.
Two extraordinary women showed us the way.
She tells us the truth, and they love her because she's crazy.
History is so beautiful, it makes you cry.
Through music, she opened our eyes to life.
You will do all the work, and I go to sleep. Have we got it all worked out then? Yeah.
Through dance, she gave us hope for the future.
Everyone laughing and singing.
I like that.
And to a young girl named Sarafina.
What do you want, mistress?
She opened her heart.
I want the war to be over.
What about the teachers?
I want the hate to be over.
Any rotten apples there?
I want to come home to kindness.
We have to support each other.
I want them to have a sense of pride in themselves.
You're playing with fire.
Through her inspiration,
people can defeat the armies.
They've discovered the courage to change the world.
Freedom is coming tomorrow.
Get ready, mama, prepare for your freedom.
Freedom is coming tomorrow.
Listen to these voices.
Academy Award winner Whoopi Goldberg and Leledi Khumalo as Sarafina.
And allow the CEO of Brand South Africa. Oh, she's wearing her school uniform. Thank you so much. You're looking wonderful. You're looking wonderful. Thank you so much, CEO Ms. Tulisile Manzini. Over to you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Pumela. Distinguished guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, and all the young people who have tuned in, even those who are very young at heart, like myself. It's my honor to welcome you on this significant day in history of South Africa. For the first time in 26 years of democracy, South Africa is commemorating the 2020 National Youth Month with restrictions as the country and the world battle with the global outbreak of COVID-19. We are meeting online due to these circumstances, and as Brand South Africa are clear in our resolve that if we cannot meet physically, we'll endeavor to meet online through the platforms available at our disposal, like this platform that we are using today. I want to welcome you to this virtual celebration of Youth Day 2020. The entire country is encouraged to participate in Youth Month by recognizing the present and future role of the youth in shaping the socio-economic landscape of the country. Today, 44 years ago, the youth of South Africa, Soweto in particular, marched against a system that was unjust. Today's youth globally faces its own challenges such as racism, unemployment, and poverty. A working youth is critical to our future. The economy depends on you. With your hard work and efforts in improving your skills, you can make South Africa one of the most prosperous nations in the world. Be thirsty for knowledge, learn, educate yourself. Nelson Mandela once said, I quote, "Education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world," close quote. Learn about your past so that you can shape the future. We look up to you as young people to hold a mirror to society and its leaders. Your young minds and your restless energy are what will drive us forward. To the young people born of South African parents abroad, we ask you to identify yourselves with your parents' country of birth, which is South Africa, and form part of the global South African network. The platform is open for you to register online at globalsouthafrican.com. We want to engage you so that you can be brand ambassadors for South Africa. For parents of the young people and South Africans who have tuned in from all over the world today, thank you so much for flying the South African flag wherever you are. Thank you for recognizing this day of national importance in our country calendar. My message today is that we must be united in our diversity wherever we are in the world. I call upon the youth to enjoy the screening of the film Sarafina and draw lessons that will shape your future. Please engage with Mbongeni Ngema, the legend, and PJ Powers, another legend, about how South Africa has come as a nation and how close the movie is to the truth. And remember that with freedom comes responsibility. I thank you.
Thank you very much, people coming in. My goodness, this is phenomenal. We have almost 1,000 people wanting to come in.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me just acknowledge those who've just written us a message. Thank you, Bulelwa. Whilst you are sorting that out, ne?
Yeah.
Thank you, Bulelwa. Thank you, Prince. Thank you, Matlo Setati. Thank you, Indlovu. My CEO, Ms. Tulisile Manzini, has also written. Linda, to everyone, Linda Nopondo, thank you. PJ Powers is saying hello to you, CEO. She says she's sending her love. She says she's sending her love to you, so you can just blow a kiss to her. Kia Clarence Mashage says, hi Tandeka, it's an honor to be interacting with you this evening. She is very, very happy. As I said, that name Tandeka, PJ Powers got from Nelson Mandela himself, because she is the one who is loved, and we love Tandeka, PJ Powers to bits. So there's Jason Fraser. Whoop, whoop. Yes, Jason is a very active global South African here in the United Kingdom. Thank you, Jason. We see you. Not in Debs, not Tandom Debele is saying Hibiri. She's already preparing for Sister Bettina. Hibiri, Hibiri. Norma Kumalo is saying yes to us, Sister Bettina. Cindy So and Laura says yes, Sizubusha Betu. Yes, it's so appropriate. We are young people, and as youth, Sizubusha Betu. And those of us who are over 35 will also remain forever young, you know. Alex says DJ Mkukwini is the best internationally. So DJ Mkukwini, there is one for you. You are the best internationally. Again, okay, so there is our CEO, Ms. Tulisi Lemanzini, saying hello, Tandeka, we meet again. Yes, they last met in Australia, ladies and gentlemen, in a global South African engagement. I do know that even today, we have people that are joining us from Australia, because again, once a South African, always a South African. Mwani, hi Mwani, Mwani is signing in, saying hello to everyone. Jabu. Is saying revolutionary greetings to all, wishing our young people a wonderful youth day from Comrade Jabu Sibego, African National Congress in the United Kingdom. I know he will be giving a message of support later on. Bernice Alexandra, another global South African in the United Kingdom, she's saying hello to everyone. There's someone here away, she says greetings to all. Alex, she says the speaker is visible online. Oh, that was when the CEO was visible. All right, Jocelyn Cragen, please also tell us where you are actually signing in from. We have Jocelyn, she says she's from South London. Thank you very much. Noli, she says she's flying the South African flag very high. She loves her country. Lindiwe Kuzuayo, she says, hi, dear South Africans. Baba Alwa says, what is the hashtag to use on other social media? Hashtag that we should use is hashtag youth power, hashtag youth month, hashtag national youth month, hashtag national youth month 2020, and hashtag youth. Okay, thank you. And then Tenji says, hello, Mams Wampumela. Hi, Tenji. Desri Chauke from SABC, she says she's excited to be here. Thank you so much, my sister. Moses Chale says, hi, my countrymen, comrades, and friends. That's Moses Chale. Michali to everyone says, hello from London, waiting for a Stimela Sasezola. Yes, we are going to play a Stimela Sasezola. And incidentally, it's my husband's favorite song as well, and he will be joining in as well. Okay, so we have Julie. She says, hi, South Africans from North London. And then the Mbongwana say, we ready for Sarafina and Stimela Sasezola. Lindiwe Kuzwayo says she's a young at heart in the UK. Yes, we want the young at heart. We want the young people to join us. Tell your friends to tell their friends. As I said, we are opening up the logging in. It seems as if we have more than 1,000 people wanting to join in. So those who came first are now catching the worm. Those early birds are catching the worm. Lily to everyone, she says hello from South London. So lovely to be back in the community, even if we have to be apart right now. Thank you so much, Lily. Priscilla says, Molwene Kaya from Essex in Romford, which is in the United Kingdom. Tenji says, hello from Mtata. Hello, Pumela, and everyone from Tenji with Aba and her mom. Yes, we want generations to be watching here. I must say, Notando Ndebele says that she grew up in Zimbabwe, where she was born. And the only, I hope Mbongeni Ngema can hear this, she says that the only film that they had in her household was Sarafina. And so they used to play it and play it and play it all over again. And so I hope that she can also take a picture of us or a video for us of her rendition of some of the dance moves. We also, I know that Buyo also reached out on Instagram and said that she has watched Sarafina so many times and she's so excited to be here and she doesn't mind watching it again. Spamandla Nala, greetings to all. She says, I'm glad you are flying the flag from all corners of the earth. We are family, we are one. Thank you, Spamandla. And then we have the Mentuendi family. They are in Milton Keynes in the United Kingdom. Then we have, she says, there's someone from an iPad. She says, oh, it's the Similas in Bedfordshire. Bedfordshire is also in the UK. They say that they're so excited and that they like feeling being South African. It's a lovely feeling to be here. Nokubonga Twetwa says, hi, Bantu Bam, my South Africans. Nokubonga Twetwa from Mtata in South Africa, in the Eastern Cape. We also have the Mtweni family from Winchester saying hello to us. PJ Power says, okay, I'm back. She's back now. She says, hi, Tuli, I'm back. So that's for you, CEO. She's back. Tammy, to everyone. She says, hi, everyone. Tammy in London. Great to see that this day is celebrated at home. She says she's still young at heart, though some will call her Mbongeni. I know she's not an Mbongeni. This lady went to fight for our freedom outside South Africa. She went into exile. And I know she won't want me to mention that, but I always believe that honor should be given where honor is due. She fought in the trenches for the freedom of South Africa. Lolwethu Sigaba, she says hello to everyone. She's logging in from Oxford. Thank you, Lolwethu. You are welcome. Tabo says Dumelang from London. We have a lot of people from the United Kingdom, which is great. PJ Powers, she says hello, everyone. This is exciting. Then we have someone from Ireland. And she says that she's still trying to log in. And I think as soon as this is open, they will be able to come in. But at the same time, having said all of this, I wouldn't like us to, waste any time. We will sort out the people that come in. But for now, I'm sure you agree, CEO, that we should now go into the movie. Oh, I see they're busy there. So I think everyone, can I just hear a yes? That we can go to the movie?
Yes, yeah.
Yes, now we can go to the movie. Okay, so please don't go away. Maybe we'll stop in between and say hello, just checking, is everyone still here? Okay, let's watch Sarafina. Can you show me your snacks or drinks? Those who are on video. I see a flag there. Who else am I missing? Okay, let me see. Oh, I see. Deva is a veteran South African who is originally from Durban, and I see he has joined us. I see him in the video as well. Jabu, Tulani Tango, these are the people I see. Ati Batman, thank you to all of you. I'm seeing Tandile Nombego there. Thank you, we see you. Yeah, everybody. Oh, we have Nicola Stadlen as well. I can see you. Thank you for joining us. Please join us on the 25th of June to watch the Nicola Stadlen's film called Life is Wonderful. Thank you to be able to, you know, watch the rest of the 5 minutes. We are wary that Dr. Mbongeni Ngema has joined us and he's ready for the discussion as we speak. But before that, we just want to have a message of support from Mr. Jabu Sibego. After that, we are going to play Stimela Sasezola. After Stimela Sasezola, we will then have the discussion with Mbongeni Ngema, the Honorable Dr. Mbongeni Ngema. Thank you so much. Mr. Jabu Sibego ready for that, for his address?
Just in a second.
Okay, quiet. I thought it was the touch.
Okay, okay.
Can you, oh, there he is. Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, everyone. Hello. First of all, let me say thank you very much for giving us this opportunity to come and talk to you. I would initially say, comrades and compatriots, friends and fellow South Africans, the African National Congress in the United Kingdom would like to take this opportunity to greet all South Africans here in the United Kingdom, in South Africa, as well as in other and other South Africans who have sought a domicile around the world. Today's commemoration and celebration are a stark reminder of the bravery of the youth of 1976. It was on this day in 1976 that the young people of South Africa took initiative and defied the apartheid regime in quest for freedom that we enjoy today. We also recognize that our young people have similar determination and hopes relating to their future in a prosperous South Africa. Notwithstanding the ongoing developments in the country, the challenge still remains. Our youth and young people are still faced with numerous challenges. I suppose it's rather important to reflect on challenges in the country as a whole in order to make a determination of how best we can engage, empower, and utilize the skill base of our youth for the betterment of our communities. It is regrettable, however, that today's global is plagued with the coronavirus pandemic. South Africa is no exception. It is recognized, therefore, that the coronavirus pandemic and its ramification has had major implications on the health, on the economy, as well as on the social effects of the lives of people in the people of South Africa. The South African government and its stakeholders have taken the necessary initiatives to prioritize the health of our community. In South Africa, we need to always remember that we are and have always been pursuing our revolution in conditions that were never our own, of our own choosing. Need I remind you that these conditions are grossly impacting on our ability to attain our desired goals of achieving a democratic society. It is for these reasons that the ideological and political clarity becomes the necessary prerequisite for our initiatives and efforts to succeed. It is imperative, therefore, that we continue to unite around strategies and tactics that are required to attain our democratic objectives. This is a need, perhaps long overdue, to encourage continued focus on radical economic transformation and ensure that people of South Africa are prosperous. This can only be achieved through growing the economy, by creating jobs, and returning the land to our people. This is the challenge that our young people need to take up and address, as well as seek to eradicate the ever-pervasive injustices and inequalities that plague our communities. Our president yesterday, I think, he has placed a challenge directly to our young to the young people of South Africa. In his speech, he stated that we have in South Africa outstanding young people. He referred to sciences, research, sports, entertainment, and other fields that they have represented the country in various global platforms and stages. He said the voices of young people in movement such as Fees Must Fall and protest against gender-based violence have been the catalyst for change. His words of encouragement were referenced with acknowledgement of the potential of people across the sectors and spaces. And the recognition is an undeniable potential and effort of young people that concludes with the recognition that young people have the means at their disposal to become the catalyst for change. In the midst of the African National Commitment, of the National Congress, the commitment and support of young people is unchangeable. We call upon young people to remain resolute and embrace the values and principles of our glorious movement, the ANC. We are confident that with your immense optimism, strength, and determination, as you build our country going forward, you will remain entrenched in efforts of transforming, building, and developing South Africa that we aspire to have. With those words, I'm encouraged to say, probably would cite Baba Oliver Tambo, he said, I quote, "The uprisings of 1976 and 1977 was, of course, the historical watershed within a short period of time. It propelled into the forefront of our struggle millions of young people." So young people are still involved in the struggle today, and they are working their hearts out. They are determined to want to see a better South Africa. Thank you very much. Amanda.
Away.
Thank you very much, Mr. Jabu Simeko, for your message of support. Towards a brighter. So that's the message that Utatu Nelson Mandela left with the youth of South Africa. And I think it is a message that Dr. Mbongeni Ngema embodies, as he has been the script writer, as he has been the history maker, as he has been the storyteller of South Africa's tapestry. I think that is a befitting way to summarize the role that Dr. Mbongeni Ngema has played in South Africa, having been an actor, having been a human rights activist, having been a movie writer, a filmmaker, a producer, a musical director, but most of all, being a legend that is living in our times. Welcome, Dr. Mbongeni Ngema, and thank you very much for the role that you have played in South Africa. And in a way, you have emancipated a lot of us, and you have shaped a lot of us in terms of our thinking and conscience, per se, if I may put it that way. We have just seen the film Sarafina. We have a number of people who have joined. To our surprise, we have been oversubscribed by having more people that had wished to join, but have not been able to join. It just shows that there is a hunger for this, but we will make the most with the ones that have joined, as they are here fully present and fully participant. I'm going to kick off with a question which has been asked by Michali Mangeni, who is one of the young people.
What it started me was a conversation that Orlando West, Vilawazi Street, who had been to a funeral, and there were many television cameras, BBC, NBC, ABC, CBS, who had been burying one of the comrades. You know, we used to bury comrades every weekend that had been shot by the police. And then one day I drove her home after the mass funeral. In her kitchen room, she was cooking for me and her and Zinzi and the kids. And then she turned and she looked at me and she said, what do you think, Mbongeni, about this state of emergency? Because we were in the state of emergency at the time that was promulgated by P.W. Porter. You know, I said, Mama, you know, you always drag me along. You always want me to interpret. When she speaks in Xhosa language, she would ask me to interpret in English to all the news channels all around the world in English. Then I asked her a question. I said, so what do you think is going to finally happen in this country? You know, I was in a group of people with Ntato Motlana, Dr. Ntato Motlana, and a whole host of people that were in the Free Mandela campaign when Mandela was in prison. I said, what do you think is going to finally happen in this country? She stopped staring her pot and she looked at me and she said, and I'm quoting her exact words. She said, Mbongeni, I wish I have a big blanket to cover the faces of the little ones so they do not see the bitter end. With those words, we ate the dinner and then I was driving home. While I was driving home, I began to see images of young school kids in their black and white uniforms singing and running, singing Freedom is Coming Tomorrow. That's when the song came to my mind. Mm-hmm. By the time I got home, I went to my piano, I started writing the song. Mm-hmm. And after that, the whole script of Sarafina just flew into my body. From Freedom is Coming Tomorrow, and the rest is history.
It is a gift. It is a gift that you were given, and it is a gift that you have shared with us as a nation and the world over. So thank you for that. Thank you for allowing yourself to be used in terms of, I'm amazed at how you say you started, the song came to you, The Freedom Is Coming Tomorrow, which has now become a signature song for Sarafina, and it also became, a signature song for the liberation of South Africa, as it were. Thank you so much for that. Okay, there's another question here that says, what inspired your choice of career? I suppose everything that we have said, that you are a movie maker, a producer, musical director, and then in addition to that, you've been an actor yourself and a human rights activist. So what motivated you to follow that route? This is an opportunity for people to be up close and personal with you. So I hope you don't mind these questions. We're digging deeper in terms of Dr. Mbongeni Ngema. Siyabonga baba.
You know, my father was a guitar player. When I was 11 years of age, I was born in Verulam in 1955 and grew up in the early 1960s. Those were the heydays of the Beatles, John Lennon, Paul McCartney, Ringo Starr, George Harrison. You know, when I grew up at the age of 11, I started picking up the guitar.
Mm.
And my father formed a band for us as the family. I ended up playing with old people. I remember so very well that I did not even have shoes. I did not even have long pants. Mm. I would wear my short pants at 11. And women and mothers would say, oh my God, this boy carrying the guitar in his hand. After that, you know, it just took me off.
Mm-hmm.
Then I started listening to bands like Queen, Freddie Mercury, Wes Montgomery. I got introduced to jazz and Mahalia Jackson and gospel, Mahlathini and the Maotela Queens, Nentombi Simanje Manje, Brasilo. When Sis Miriam in the early 60s, when he went overseas with King Kong and Huma Sigela and Kaifa Semenya, it was all those sounds that just made me and Radio Bantu, before it was called Radio Zulu, all those sounds that I was listening to that actually, you know, configurated the human being that I am today.
Wow, that is rich. How many of us knew that Radio Zulu, which became Ukhozi FM now, used to be Radio Bantu? This is rich history. I hope we are all taking notes. I'm going to ask Mbongeni that we have a slight break where we give the mayor of Milton Keynes, Mayor Andrew Gari, to give us his message of support. And then we are going to continue with our conversation with you. Let's pretend we're all sitting around the fire and we're having this conversation. However, for now, we're gonna have this message of support from the United Kingdom, the mayor of Milton Keynes, who is always the one that willingly opens his doors, if I may put it that way, for the youth celebrations in the United Kingdom to be held. So let us give this moment to the mayor, and then we will continue. Sorry about that. He has a commitment that he has to rush to in 10 minutes. So we're giving him that opportunity. Thank you very much, Mayor.
Thank you so much for inviting me to be part of this evening. I can see that you're having fun, and I almost feel guilty for interrupting that. I was thoroughly enjoying it, and I did say to Augustine that I would be quite happy just to continue listening, but he sort of insisted that I said just a very few words, and so that's what I'm going to do. I just wanted to show my support for what you're doing, for the great celebration that you're putting on this evening, and for continuing to remember those parts of your history, which I know will have very painful memories, which will bring back some issues for some people that, you know, that remember it well and firsthand, that will be incredibly painful and incredibly difficult. But we learn from our history. as to how we shape our future. And I think some of the things that we're seeing around the Black Lives Matter campaign in Great Britain at the moment are just proving how incredibly true that is. So I wanted to commend you for the way in which you continue this and that you commemorate that every year, but you turn it into a party and a celebration, which you've invited me graciously to join this evening, and I'm thoroughly enjoying doing. There's South Africans are some wonderful people. I have some very personal and dear friends in the United Kingdom, in Milton Keynes, who originate from South Africa and who've come over here to Britain and chosen to make that their home. They've integrated into our community and they form a fundamental part, both in Milton Keynes and in the United Kingdom. But the role in which they play here in Milton Keynes, of which I'm so privileged to be the first citizen this year, is not to be underestimated. They really are some wonderful people, always with a good sense of humour, always smiling, always wanting to be appreciated and always willing to stop and chat, no matter where you are or whoever you speak to. And the good bit of banter that I have with them as a sports fan and putting sport at kind of really at the heart of my year as mayor is always around cricket and rugby, because if there's one thing I'm not going to thank South Africa for, and that I'm going to get in before you do and rub my nose in it, is a certain Rugby World Cup that took place just a few months ago. Congratulations, South Africa. You really showed us up. You really showed us how it ought to be done. We didn't come up to the game, and you did. Enjoy your evening, and thank you for inviting me to be part of it.
Thank you very much there to the mayor of Milton Keynes. And I do hope that when we are able to meet again physically, you continue to open your doors for us. Thank you for having joined us. I saw you in the beginning. You have been here throughout. You have had resilience to stay with us on switching off, but you stayed with us. Thank you very much. And for that, I will reward you with a South African rugby shirt.
thank you so much.
I will make sure that you get that as soon as lockdown is over, your own shirt of the Springboks.
I will never ever live that down if I wear that in front of some of my friends, I can tell you. But thank you very much. And I look forward to welcoming you in person as soon as we possibly can.
Yes, we will baptize you as an official friend of South Africa with that. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. We appreciate you. We appreciate you for your time and for the gift of your time. I know your schedule is busy, but you took it upon yourself to stay with us throughout. Thank you very much. We don't take that for granted and we don't take it lightly. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
My pleasure. Good to be here.
Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was Mayor Andrew Gary, the mayor of Milton Keynes, and you've seen that he's had good things to say about South Africans in the area. As a country, one of our assets that we are very proud of is our people. So as Brand South Africa, we are glad when we are hearing that in the communities that South Africans live in, you are making positive. Thank you very much for that. We will continue then with our conversations with Dr. Mbongeni Ngema. I see Moses from South African High Commission. Welcome, sir. We wish to acknowledge you. Yes, here I see, I'm like big brother. I see everybody. Right. Now, Babu Ngema, there are some more questions for you. There is a question here that is asking, what keeps you going? I think, what is your motivation in life? If I'm asking the question correctly, where do you draw your motivation from? Everyone mute their devices, please. Thank you. So what's your inspiration, Baba? What keeps you going? There are a lot of positive messages here. One says, we celebrate you. You are an amazing legend. I hope Ubaba can hear me. Can Ubaba Ngema hear me?
I can't hear you clearly. What's the question?
Baba, she's saying, what keeps you going? What is your inspiration?
Oh, you know what? My inspiration is always young people.
Nice.
you know, like in Sarafina, I've always worked with young people all my life. And I think, I don't know whether it's a curse or what, but God gave me, God gave me young people. Wow. And like right now, you know, I've just done this new remix version of Freedom Is Coming Tomorrow with these young people around me.
Lovely.
And Jay Mashaba. You know,
these are our biggest stars at the moment. For those who don't know, these guys are actually running things at the moment in SA.
In SA, isn't this the song that's being released on the 18th of June? Wonderful, we're hearing it first on this platform. Yes,
I'm going to stop talking because the young people's voices sound better than me. Okay.
Come on. Let's hear the snippet.
Wow, they say ladies first. So the song is basically featuring some very amazing acts. I think people who have stayed true to the kind of narrative that Ubaba Mbongeni always played into, right? And we've got a lot of like conscious rappers. We've got like amazing award-winning musicians on it. Yeah, myself as Gigi. I'm also here. And I think it was like kind of something, you know, that everyone has experienced right now. Tamasha, MT, Saudi, Reason. Yeah. A lot of lyricists that, you know, a lot of South Africans, I guess, are like.
Please unmute Dr. Ngema, DJ Mpukwin. Please unmute him.
Oh. Is it on now?
Yes, please. Thank you.
First now?
Yeah, now we're back.
Yes.
Sorry for that.
So the song features a lot of amazing artists, but I think from a, you know, a consciousness perspective, Black Liz, who is here today, MJ, myself, Tamasha, Saudi, MT, Reason, who are still on the way. And, you know, it's so true when he says that he is somebody who naturally just likes to work around with young people. I think, you know, for me, I guess, as a born free, a 94 child, it's kind of wild that we are young people who sat, watched Sarafina, knew all the words back to front. And, you know, when you get a call to work on such an amazing project and one of the lead singles to such a, I would say single, but such a movement, that is a huge thing for us. For the fact that, you know, it's like we had our struggles as people who are part of a very different, you know, generation, and now we're reaching out to you to find out what your struggles are. So the single basically, you know, shines on that. Everybody from different walks of life, you know, an award winner, you know, a lyricist, an amazing, you know, vocalist, amazing songwriting and production brought back into 2020. I remember seeing somebody say, because Sarafina was actually on our screens yesterday, and somebody said, why would anyone want to remake anything from Sarafina? And somebody answered and they said, it's very important because my kids need to be able to relate to that. And I think that's something Ubaba was able to do, bring that back, get children who speak to other children to be able to understand that the struggle is far from over. You know, back then it was, there were so many other dynamics, but now we face so many things right here in South Africa, gender-based violence. We face, you know, racism, not as what it is now, but systematically. Mm. And I think every musician came through to be able to speak on those things. And I think we're all sitting here saying, wow, we're on it. You know, he could have chosen anyone, but I guess we're here and the narrative can carry on for anybody in a diaspora, whether you're in England, whether you're in New York, everyone can relate to it. And yeah, I think we're super on it.
Preach.
MJ, please, man.
What do I say after that? I mean, this is the type of, you know, queens we have in South Africa. Very young, but very clued up about what's really going on socially. And wow, thanks for sharing those views.
You
actually literally said everything that we could all say, but just to echo some of the things you were saying. First of all, we are all grateful to Dr. Mbongeni Ngema for even considering us. Mm. You know, personally, I know there's like way bigger artists than me that deserved probably a spot on the song way more than me. But somehow you saw something in me, and I really appreciate that. Mm. Appreciate working with so many great talents: Gigi LeMain, MT, Black Les, Reason, Saudi, Tamasha. I mean, you just really have to listen to the song to understand everything that Gigi said is literally on that song, on the remix, where we really touch on the issues. Come again?
No. Sorry, I was saying wonderful. Yeah. Sorry.
All right. Cool. So literally that song touches on the issues that we're going through right now. And we're all different. Our takes are all different. Yeah. You know, economic issues. Yeah. Even some of us take it back as well, because we were there, you know, 94. Yeah. We were there and we experienced some of the things that, you know, our parents experienced. And we also see how far we've come as well. So we do celebrate that as well. Yeah. You know, so the struggle was definitely not in vain, and Sarafina as a movie will always be relevant.
Absolutely.
You know, and because why? Young people will always be there. You know, the next generation is waiting to also create their own history. And what an honor to do it with the man himself. You know, the man that created history back in 92, now he's doing it again in 2020. And I'm just excited for everybody to hear it all over the world. In fact, there was a time where I stayed overseas. And trust me, every person that saw me, everything they knew about South Africa was from Sarafina.
Absolutely, I agree. Everywhere you go.
Oh, that is lovely. We are glad as brand South Africa, because we are
Black Les.
You're gonna get Black Les in.
Black Les, okay.
Yes. So they call him.
I'm not gonna get even just a 1 second of this song.
Listen, he actually looks like, you know, Samora Machel.
Yeah, and the worst part is they call him the new age Steve Biko, right?
Yeah,
everybody
looks like Samora.
Power to you.
Samora was actually, that was the pinnacle, that was the turning point in our struggle for liberation, when Samora Machel decided to take an AK-47 to attack the Portuguese people. Okay, let's go.
Yes, I'm not going to speak for long. I just want to say that I appreciate that the struggle is different for young people. And I, apart from the fact that it was a huge honor to be called on this song, one of the biggest things is that I felt I needed to be an appropriate voice. I think young South Africans, because you look at people like Abu Babu Mbongeni and Solomon Mahlangu, Tieti Mashinini, you name them. Those were people that loved this country. Those are people that loved the people of this country, people who loved South Africans. And they gave their lives. Yeah. Some of them are not here today to see what we call freedom. And I believe that Ubabu Ngema, when they made Freedom is Coming, they believe that freedom is coming. But freedom for us is not going to come completely and as a whole, it's going to come in waves. So what is the next wave? The first wave was to ensure that their children can walk the streets. Their children can have a voice. Their children, now they've passed the baton. What are their children doing with the baton that's been passed to them? Because the easiest thing is to say, the government needs to do this for us, whatnot. But that generation didn't just look to government, didn't just look to their elders. That generation said, we're going to go out and do this. So we're a generation that needs to somehow find a way to see what our struggles are. What is the freedom that we seek? And I think that's what Ubabu Ngema is trying to see, because I cannot rehash what they went through back then. I cannot tell their story, but I can tell ours. What is our story? Number one, top of the list, gender-based violence, economic exclusion, rape, poverty, unemployment. How do we move from that wave to the new wave? Because a revolution will never end. What I've understood is that in life, you never arrive. There's never a ceiling, because you'll never explore your full potential. And I think even after us, You know, we have lost artists in this country, the likes of Pro Kid, WHP, name the OGs. Who are the OGs?
So many,
a lot of them.
So
and what's scary is that now we are it. We are the ones that are supposed to carry the baton and pass it to someone else with the new wave of the struggle, a new wave of freedom. So, yeah, that's it. That's me.
Wow.
Hey, man.
Wow. Come on, man.
Wow.
I know
Nishaile.
Wow. I am not going to give up on my request for a just a teaser nyana of this new version of freedom. And then after that, I'm going to give to DJ Mkukwini to ask, you know, a few questions further to Dr. Mbongeni Ngema. I have to share with you, this is a moment we have, you know, been dreaming of. I think DJ Mkukwini is probably very emotional right now. We all are. We appreciate this time to have you, Mbongeni Ngema. We appreciate what you've done for our country. We appreciate what you've done for us. But let me not speak any further, except to just ask for that teaser, nyana, and then I'll give over to DJ Mkukwini to just have a conversation with Mbongeni Ngema. But
I was meant to have it. I don't know if it's there on my email.
Yeah, so what we're going to do is we're sending it to you right now.
I'll
so,
pay.
Okay, let me tell
from the same email. Okay.
Whilst he's looking for the email, can you do like a cappella or something that you do? With the...
Yeah, we can.
We can do it.
Hold on. We can.
Yes.
So, pardon me if I read. Actually, I'm not. So, I'm going to read the words and I'm going to explain.
No.
I'm going to
play.
I think that's enough.
Play.
Your voices. You want to hear your voices.
Yes, no, definitely, definitely.
DJ, pin them on the big screen.
On the big screen, okay. I think school DJ Mkukwini is busy trying to open the email. Okay, here we have them, Mr. Mtwin. We have them on the big screen.
So I'm just keeping them busy.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Coming.
3.
Okay. No, can I please start so that the pressure is off me?
Okay, start.
Because when Black Lives comes in, it's too hot. You know, they do say ladies first. Ladies, what?
Oh, you got the song.
Play it. No.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, wait. I'm looking for mine. I got my phone out lost.
So. Okay, can I?
Okay, go.
Okay, here's mine. Crocodile tears, that's Sarafina. How do you wear a mufati di sutra kinna? Bophelo botata modimo supa tsela khale mathata a shapa thupa fela. The heroes would have liked to meet them, but the fact is blood is the price of freedom. From the doldrums, try find a life of meaning. You were born to win, so don't fight the feeling. The new wave looking for a new way. Explore both sides of the coin, but don't be two-faced, squeezing out the toothpaste. Poverty's a toothache. Take you to the promised land. Kasili Jupe. So,
wow.
He's a toothache.
Oh, no, man. It sounded like
okay, Gigi, okay, come on.
Okay, this is mine.
Yeah.
Are you guys ready to get the song? Because I think I can give a preview.
Okay, go ahead.
My last one. This is your debut, and then we're going to continue with the conversation.
Okay.
United Kingdom, United States of America, we are launching you now. Go for it.
Yeah. Too much pressure.
Let's go.
This is the elevation of the new school. Ooh. This is the revelation of the hood. You're going to change your stance in every stride, every move. Like, let Tambulu be your muse to this new.
What else?
Freedom came and she saw and she conquered. For every little girl graduating out of college, we walked and we flew. It was a long road, too. Mm. Now I'm yelling in the hood.
Zozi Bini, what's good?
Yo. Wakali Scoop. Yo. Bakalum cool.
I went.
Tell them to remember that they grew from these roots and they never should deter from the kings and the Moors that they come from. And we gonna sing it on the same song, walking to Soweto with our martyrs and they latch on, singing to the heavens and they heard your prayers. And when you're yearning for a future, you've got nothing to fear.
Listen.
Reason just joined us.
MJ, 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 MJ.
She's saying something.
What?
Now we know this is being released official on the 18th of June. And so everyone who's here is going to be
on the 19th, Friday.
19th of Friday.
Okay, on the 19th of June. The beauty is that we've had a teaser here. And everyone is now aware of the young people, the new generation, the born frees, as they say, who are behind this. We are so grateful, Baba, that you are bringing others as you rise as well. So, DJ Mkukwini, I know it's emotional for you, Baba, but this is your moment.
Yeah. Angbonge ngomusa wakho nokuthi for you to give yourself time to this project, because you could have been somewhere, you could have been doing something. But what gets me emotional is that you did not think twice when I asked you. You just
went for it.
And the question you asked me, Wuti, what are we teaching? Who are we teaching? When I mentioned the youth, you just jumped on it. And I don't have much words. All I can say is, on behalf of the whole, not South Africa, because you're no longer a South African icon, on behalf of the whole world, we appreciate you and we thank you. Our weakness as people, we don't thank our stars while they're still alive. And this is my moment and my opportunity. I'm sorry, I'm a bit emotional, because the Youth Day is deeper than what we actually do. I just want to say we appreciate you and we thank you for everything you've done, and we thank you for your time. I'm not gonna ask any questions because I already know everything.
Just two verses.
Please. Okay. All right.
Should I go for it?
I'm chatting to Bulela on this side.
Yes, please. Yes, please. Thank you.
Okay. Yes, please. MGZ in a building. Ooh. I came from a village. I was looking for a million. Eish. Just to stack it to the ceiling. But freedom had other plans. It's bigger than Mercedes Benz. It's bigger than stacking rents. It's eagles spreading out their wings. Nkensa kukateka. Malian fanela. Mfanalo saseka. Nikongalela Africa.
Okay,
you
go for it.
You have to do the beatbox. Do you know what I mean? You have to do the beat.
Okay, okay, now, Rizin.
Legend.
I refuse to view this lockdown as a sentence, because I will not lose my hair from this extension, because I see many are falling, I'm still standing. Gotta keep it moving and not lose the momentum, because real love will cover the distance. So just let go of the tension. Forget about all your mentions and just prepare for your
freedom.
No one knows what the future holds and what is next, but Lord behold, if you're safe at home, you should think about,
think about it.
Are you talking? Give up. Those ad libs. Are you a jailer in a safe house? Thank you. How are you, sir?
Thank you. I'm good. You see, this is what I live around, man. I live around these kids with me, and they fulfill my life. This is my life. You know, they make me feel young. That's why today everybody was asking me, how do you feel? Because you were there in 1976. Yeah. I say to them, I am the youth of 2020 today, June 16, as I was the youth of 1976.
Yes.
You will be forever young. You will be forever young. I think that a tree that waters others will never go dry. So thank you. Thank you for being my tree. I think the last question that we'll take from the audience that's here is from, it says, what are your current thoughts about what the young people are going through right now? And then there's one that's related to the last rhyme that we had. Let me just read it. I mean, it's already been addressed actually in the song. It says, first of all, do you think that there will be a remake of Sarafina focusing on the current struggles that the youth of South Africa are facing?
House on the couch sitting. Oh, I love the love seat. I do. Does him let the sofa couch or the love seat?
Can you hear me?
Someone.
Okay, can other people please mute their mic and then we leave Dr. Mbongeni's mic on?
I think the struggles of the young people today
are
very vast, unfortunately, unlike our times. We are at a time when young people are exposed to so many things and drugs like Wunga, Nyaupe, you know, COVID-19, you know, AIDS, Ebola,
unemployment,
racism, which is an overarching problem for African people in Africa and in the diaspora. It's a huge problem. And no one wants to address the fact that we as African people have been oppressed since they started taking slaves. Our great, great, great fathers and mothers from Africa to everywhere in the world. And now they are blaming it on Africa. They are blaming the diseases on Africa. It just makes me so emotional. He didn't talk about it. And young people without political knowledge, without anthropological knowledge, without scientific knowledge, they are faced with these challenges today. And when I see a black child, I just want to weep, because a black child is faced with these challenges that were created by white people, by Europeans, including the Bible itself. Okay, let me not even go there because that's another different subject.
Second question is,
there will be a remake of Sarafina. It may not be called Sarafina. It will be called something else. I've just written a very beautiful script that I want to share with these lovely young people that I'm with today.
Mm.
I've just written a script that I call 10 Times Beauty. You know why I call it 10 Times Beauty? It is because a father had this beautiful daughter in Soweto. And every night he would put 10 flowers on her pillow. And when she wakes up, she sees the flowers and he would say, "You are 10 times beauty." It's based on a true story of a woman who I met in Canada who could not speak anymore, who had lost her speech because of the atrocities of apartheid. She was an MK cadet. That's the story that I want to tell you next.
Wow, ladies and gentlemen.
You're wrong in that story.
I think that Ubabu Ngema has answered, a number of the questions. I do know that we could stay here until 12 midnight South Africa time, 12 midnight UK time, and 12 midnight United States of America time, as we have people joining us from all these parts of the world. But we can never thank you enough, Baba. Know that you have our support, and we hope that when lockdown is over, we will one day have then the launch of this new song here in the United Kingdom, because most of the community members that are here in the United Kingdom, and we also have a number of people joining us from South Africa. But when there's no longer social distancing, we do hope to see you with all the young people in person performing in the United Kingdom. I'm sure the team that is here, Evangelist, Trini, DJ Mkukwini, Jabu, Sibeko, I'm sure you all agree that we do need something in whatever shape or form in the United Kingdom in the near future. Everyone can just say hands up if you agree. Thank you for your, yes, I see everyone saying hands up.
Siyabonga.
Siyabonga, baba, sibonga ngesikhathi sakho, sibonga ukuthi ungadinwa ukuthi uphuhlise young people. And for the young people that are in your midst, you are so blessed. You are so, so blessed. And just milk everything out of, you know, this opportunity. Everybody would have such an opportunity. And to my brother out there who was rapping in Tsonga, Shikwembu Shikukatekise.
Oh,
thank you.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Wonderful. Okay. Thank you.
How are you, Master Josh?
Are we good? Thank you. Thank you for wearing your scarf, your South African scarf.
Of course.
Yes, yes. Thank you so
much. Play your part. I'm an ambassador.
Yes, play your part.
Play your part. Play your part.
Jabulani.
I've been playing in the rain. Jabulani.
Jabulani.
Oh, Nina. How are you, my friend?
PJ, Gunjani.
What's called Ninjani? Really?
Yabila.
These young people you've got next to you, I need to record with them as well. You've got to share.
Hey. No. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too. Still the best mouth in town.
Oh, this is so beautiful. Thank you so much. PJ, two questions to start off. One, how did you become Tandeka? Because not everybody knows that you are Tandeka.
Yes, PJ, Tandeka is, first of all, I'd like to clarify something. It's not a nickname. It's my other name. It's in my passport. So it's not a nickname. And what happened was, in 1983, as we know, South Africa was a very different country from a country that we see today. Even what we heard on the airwaves was segregated. Radio Zulu played isiZulu, Xhosa played isiXhosa, Tsonga played Tsonga, Pedi played Pedi, Afrikaans played Afrikaans. I'm not sure what the English were doing, but anyway, they were playing something. But I wrote a simple love song called You're So Good to Me, which was suddenly, it's so interesting hearing Mbongeni speak about Radio Zulu and hearing you talk about that it was Radio Bantu. And it suddenly got onto the then Radio Zulu charts. A DJ by the name of Kansas City and Vivio, way back then in those days, they suddenly decided that they weren't going to listen to the regime at the time and that they were going to play my song, You're So Good to Me. And it suddenly became, it was like a felt fire. It suddenly became this enormous hit in Black South Africa, which was really strange because me being a white woman, living in a country and the basically as being the color of the oppressor and the oppressed, picking up on a song that I'd written. And I was invited to play at the Jabulani Amphitheater in Soweto. And it was the 31st of May, 1983. And it was on that day that I went on stage for the first time and played You're So Good to Me. And 30,000 people at the Jabulani Amphitheater sang along with me. And at the end of the show, at the end of the song, Collins Mashego came on stage and he said, what are we going to call this woman? We need to marry her to Soweto. And the crowd, it was amazing. Some people said Tandi or Tandiwe, but we settled on Tandeka. And I drank some unkomboti from a calabash. And it was that day, and I can honestly say this, that was the first day that I felt unconditional love. Mm. I think as somebody that has English heritage, we come from a very stiff upper lip culture. Mm-hmm. And so love was not, it was felt, but it was not easily shown. Mm-hmm. And it was the first time that I felt unconditional love. And on that day, on the 31st of May, 1983, that was my first soft landing. Mm-hmm. So for me, Black lives matter. Mm-hmm. Because in my life, Black lives matter. They mattered to me. They have made me who I am. They have put me where I am. And they have given me the experience. It is Black lives that have given me the experiences and the wonderful life that I have enjoyed and am still enjoying. Mm. So on the subject of that, before somebody asks me, because it's bound to come up, yes, Black lives matter a lot.
That's so beautiful. Personally
and globally.
That's so beautiful. Already the comments are saying Tandeka still beautiful. You maturing like fine wine. Someone is saying Tandeka, you're still looking good and you're looking young. Another one in London is saying respect, sister. And then another one saying respect, Yeah, Sean Tamsanga is saying respect. JJ Tandeka, all the love. Jocelyn Krogan is saying respect, sister. Matlos the Tati says, that's South Africa for you. Thank you for the beautiful story, Tandeka. And then they're saying that the name is a good choice. It's a good choice of name. And there's just love. There's just love. There's just love that's filling this place. I mean, if I'm looking at all the comments, and everyone is just everyone just loves you. And I think, I mean, speaking for myself, having met OPJ Powers when she's been performing here in London, you cannot help but fall in love with this beautiful soul. She's beautiful inside out, and she's a true epitome of what, you know, South Africa is about. And so I'm thankful for that day on the 31st of May, 1983, when you were initiated into Soweto. So that is your birth date in addition to... in addition to your Penelope. I'm letting the cat out of the bag.
You can let the cat out the bag. It's fine.
Yes, Penelope.
Penelope Jane. Yes, Penelope Jane.
All right, then. Now, can you share with us your experiences of South Africa then, during the apartheid era, and your experiences of South Africa now? And I know that you will speak from your heart. Just speak from your heart. How has South Africa been over the years? And talk to the born frees as well, those who were born after 1994. What is it that they never experienced in South Africa? And how is it vis-a-vis where we are today?
Well, I think, you know, I think that to the born frees, first of all, in order to know, and to people, young people, irrespective of their color or their race, young people in South Africa, in order to know why we are where we are today, we have to know where we have come from. And that is vitally important. And I feel that perhaps it's understudied in school, and as in, when I mean understudied, not studied enough. Our history, we need to know who our struggle heroes are. We need to investigate the lives of the Joe Slovers, the Ruth Firsts, the Stephen Bikos. I mean, it needs to be properly told, that story, over and over again, because lest we should forget. Apartheid South Africa was, as a white person growing up in South Africa, it was an embarrassing yoke to have to wear, because instantly and understandably, people thought that the color of my skin meant that I was racist. And by virtue of the color of my skin and being born in South Africa, it's very difficult to say I'm not racist. To say I'm not racist is not enough. I'm afraid the one part in Sarafina that I found so incredibly poignant for me was when the policeman was in the classroom and he spoke to John Carney. And he said to John Carney's character, it is not enough, and to Whoopi Goldberg, he said to them, it's not enough that you denounce violence. When John Carney says, we do not preach violence in our schools, he said, the policeman, the white policeman, turned around and said, it's not enough to renounce violence. You have to actively fight against violence. And that's what I feel about racism. I feel that not enough, particularly for whites, to just say, I'm not a racist. You have to, and say, I don't, my views are not racist. We have to actively fight against racism. We have to fight against it in our psyches. We have to fight against it in our reflex, knee-jerk reactions. And I honestly do think that that apartheid South Africa, and what amazed me was that we sit today with many children under a new regime, and a regime that I fought to be in power, and children are still suffering. Young people are still suffering. Perhaps not in terms of violence. Obviously, I'm not talking about domestic violence. I'm talking about governmental violence. But lack of amenities, lack of that kind of thing, have to be addressed, because in a way, our children are still being abused with the lacks. But I see young people as being, I don't want to, unlike Udada Mbongeni, I don't see black youth as being victims. I'm mixed with a lot of Black youth. And I like to collaborate. I'm much like Mbongeni said, I like to be around people that are younger than myself because I feel that they enrich my soul. And I see such bravery and I see so much, because of the technical age, people that are so much more in control. And as that young gentleman was saying, it's time for us to take, the baton has been passed. It's time to pick it up and run with it. But apartheid South Africa was an embarrassment for me. It was an embarrassment to travel. We were the pariahs of the world, and rightly so. And how I see it changing is, well, first of all, it's changed a lot. I mean, people that say we've made no progress in South Africa, they've got to be deaf, dumb, and blind, because we've made enormous progress in the last 24 years. If you just, what you need to do is rewind that movie to the beginning of, to the beginning of the 90s, which was one of the most violent periods in our history. And 4 years later, 4 years later, we voted in our first democratically elected president. So I see, for me, I was lucky in that I had parents and a grandmother who was a communist. So I was exposed to townships and people without at a very young age. I came from myself from privilege, but I was very exposed to people without and very aware of people without. And I urge all South Africans to look into our history. And that's why, thank you, Pamela, and Brand South Africa for doing this. And I see that my sister, Ntuli Sile, the CEO, are you still there, Ntuli?
She said thank you for being a brand ambassador. She's thanking me.
And I, you know, being part of global South Africans and being an ambassador for Brand South Africa, being able to go around the world and actually encourage people to look carefully at South Africa before you judge us. Yeah. Look carefully at how alive we are with possibilities.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so ask us questions for Tandeka. All I'm seeing here is love, love, love. So
All we need is love.
I'm noting you, DJ Mkukini. I just want to say, Mzika Azizi says, wow, that's a beautiful story, Tandeka. Vuvu Nomonde says, such warmth in your words. Another one is calling you Mbokodo. And then the Asian Africa says, beautiful story about how your name came about. They love your work, love your spirit of Ubuntu. Portia Roberts says, Ubuntu. Moms are a group of South African moms who echo your ethos and the diversity of South Africa and the UK. What message do you have for them on how they can educate their kids about Ubuntu, the way you have embraced it? This is Portia Roberts in the UK saying, how do you teach young ones about Ubuntu?
I think the best way to teach young people about Ubuntu is to act. Be the change you want to be. Unfortunately, it sounds trite, but young people learn from actions, not words. So we have to be the Ubuntu that we want. We need mountains of Ubuntu to be poured back into South Africans and Africans. Let's not forget that we're part of a continent. We're part of a greater African continent that is in desperate need of kindness and care towards each other. And that is the finest way that we can promulgate Ubuntu is to be Ubuntu, to show Ubuntu by showing our children what it is to be kind and to be sharing and to be giving. And those are the most important lessons to give anyone, because once you have care and kindness in your heart, it doesn't go. You can't unlearn that behavior. You can't unsee what you have seen. So whilst you can't unsee violence and oppression, you also can't unsee hope and love and care and kindness.
Mm-hmm. Wow, Wow, that's powerful. So, Portia Roberts, there's your answer. Give the kids kindness. Give them, share with them, and show them how to give. So, kindness, sharing, giving. That's very key. More messages of love. One says you're amazing. PJ Powers. Bernice Alexander says, thank you, Tandeka, for sharing your feelings on Black Lives Matter. Can you just say a few words in Zulu? Luyolo says, can you just say a few words in Zulu? So maybe you'll say your favorite phrase in Zulu. Anything in Zulu?
Azujabulile ukubona.
Nice. Okay, there you go. She says she's happy to see everyone here. I see DJ Mkukwini has his hand up. Yes, sir.
Oh, Bengisi, ngicela ukuxolisa to you, ngisazokhuluma no PJ as well. Ubaba Ngema has got another agent meeting that he needs to go to. So, bekafuna ukuthi simkhulule.
All right.
If we could set him free and then we can continue with the program.
Okay. And thank you for what you are doing for young people whom we are celebrating today. And I promise you that if you continue to surround yourself with the young people as you are now, you will remain forever young.
Thank you.
I've got a message here from Mamulindi Weposwa for you. Mbongeni Ulindi Weposwa, who's been here in the UK for more than 20 years, says, we are among a Mazlokovu. Yes. So I nearly missed that. I would have gone against my elders' wishes. So
Mama,
okay. Thank you, Mama. Thank you.
I love you. Thank you.
You wanna continue with the conversation?
No. You go on, Sisi. I just want to thank PJ once more. And we had a very brief conversation earlier. Thank you so much. Same thing, same feeling that Mbongeni gave us. We have goosebumps. People like you, we actually appreciate you and we want to thank you while you're still alive. We don't want to be celebrating you when you're gone. So
I'm not going to ever die.
So on behalf of everyone, we appreciate you. You are our connecting link, to be honest, between the Black people and the white people.
Yeah.
I want to say something. I want to thank the Black people of South Africa for having made me feel loved and cared for and carrying me under the wings, under their wings. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. I don't mean that in any other way, other than I'm truly grateful, and not a day goes by when I don't feel incredibly lucky and grateful.
Wow. Me, I think I'm not a speaker, so I get too emotional with all these things, because for me, this is like a dream, and I wish we could all come together and realize see the bigger picture and come together as human beings and, you know, I know we had a conversation. You don't see color. I don't see color.
Everybody,
we are all one people. And thank you. I'll think I can tell you this card.
Siabonga.
Siabonga. And there's a question that's being asked here on the Zoom chat. And I'm going to ask it mainly because I know that Utandega can handle this question as raw as it is. There's someone who's asking, what is your feeling on how white people all over the world can overcome the guilt of white privilege?
I think that the way to overcome the guilt and denial of white privilege, because denial is also a problem, and the best way to do that is to look it in the eyes. I think that when we have an ostrich mentality, And I think that the sooner that white people globally pick up this thing that they hide, that they're ashamed of, nobody, irrespective of your color, wants to stare at something that you were embarrassed of and ashamed of. Whatever it is. But the sooner we actually look at it and say, we're sorry. And I don't mean we're sorry by getting your feet washed in a central square, by, you know, I mean washing black people's feet and going, and I saw some bizarre pictures in America of people with yolks lying on the floor. I think that makes a bit of a mockery of what we're trying to achieve here. And how white people can get over their guilt is by facing it and saying, we have been the people that have been privileged, we have been, and put it in the, face it and put it in the past. You know, nobody looks at the German race as if they are not, as if they're a country of Nazis anymore, because they owned the label and they were able to move on. And the sooner we as white people say we have been privileged, but now it's time to level the playing fields and let's share this. That is the time. And then the guilt will subside. But like anything, it takes a while. But we're not going to be able to move on for anything while we're still in denial of what we have been privileged about.
Wow. You see why our CEO, Ms. Tulisile Manzini, is proud of you being our brand ambassador. It couldn't have been said better. And even the comments that are coming here, I think there's more comments that are really encouraging you. And this one is also saying on behalf of women, they want to thank you. So you've also played a role as well. Yes, and somebody said they wanted to hear you speak Zulu. Oh, there's Portia Roberts going like this there.
I saw Portia Roberts earlier. I know exactly what Portia Roberts looks like.
Yeah, she's like Mbogodo. Yes. And DJ Mkukini, someone is saying Kaland or the Kala. So he says you're allowed to cry.
Yeah.
You're allowed to cry.
Yeah, it's actually beautiful tears. It's not sad tears. It's those emotional tears of testimonies and what we, the main thing is that we have to teach our younger ones what the Youth Day is all about. Yeah. And for that, I'm grateful to who put Elias, Nokasti, Milton Keynes, Abo Bahle, a lot of people that have actually changed the way everyone sees the Youth Day, because it was about partying. But now it's actually about us teaching the younger people. And I'm even learning some things that I didn't even know. And I'm sure some people here are actually learning quite a few things. And right now we've got Usis PJ, and she's actually sharing a lot of things that most people are scared to talk about. So you see, these are emotional times, and these are beautiful times where we should actually appreciate one another and actually pull one another through whatever, especially for a community that is in the UK. We are so divided in so many ways. So yeah, I guess people can see my emotions because I can't hide them.
I can.
We appreciate you.
Bless you.
We really do. Tandeka, any last words from you, and then we will then, you know, wrap it up.
Well, the last words, yeah, to the youth, it's Happy Youth Day. To all of us globally who are living under bizarre, absurd circumstances with this COVID-19, I send you love and best wishes, and we will get through this. We shall overcome. We have to be patient. We have to be safe. I will be in the UK very, very shortly, soon after lockdown, to be able to do something as a brand ambassador and as a global South African citizen. My last words are, when you think that you can't hold on anymore at this time, then just hold on and hold on. And then when you think you can't, hold on some more.
Oh. That is so beautiful. Such encouraging words that are giving us hope. And we will see more of PJ Powers in Wales once the lockdown is over. So for those of you who have not been able to interact with her today, know that in Wales, as soon as they say lockdown off, contact us. You'll see PJ Powers. We're going to have a global South African event in Wales, and she's going to be there performing live. So it's not over. It's not over with PJ.
Pumela, my last words are to you and to Brand South Africa. Okay. The last time I was in London performing, the next thing, Pumela came flying through the door. And I think that was the same night that we heard that Robert Mugabe was no longer the president of Zim. I remember the news came through. It was at a show in Wimbledon that you came to, remember? I just want to say that as an ambassador for my country and for Brand South Africa, I'm very proud, and thank you for inviting me onto this platform, because I think that what DJ said is right, actually, which is we would normally just be out partying madly on this Youth Day, but this has brought a nuance to Youth Day. And you, Brand South Africa, sitting in England and in London, and I know a lot of my friends have tuned in, you've brought something extra to Youth Day. And I think irrespective of where we are next year, I think we should do this again. I think we should do more of this stuff, because it's actually, surprisingly enough, even though it's through this medium, it's more personal. So thank you for connecting us.
I would like to read a message to you from Lily Fraser. Lily Fraser is very special to me. She's a young global South African who's been here in London and very passionate about the country. I think she's someone you can coach, Sis Tandega.
Okay.
She says, thank you, Tandega. Please continue to raise your voice and to amplify through South African voices to teach us how to face our faults and turn the world into the place it should be. And I don't think that Lily Fraser will mind if I call a white South African, so that I can put the context into this. So you are an inspiration to young and upcoming South Africans as well. Lily, thank you for all you are. Thank you.
Thank you for all you are. I love you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. DJ, did you want to say something?
No, abengithi abo bhuti bakhona lana, I think Ubra Elias and Sis Ntombi, if they wanted to say something, if they can have that opportunity before.
Yes. Can we start with the son? I'm gonna call him my son, Uati Batman, please, so that he gives us a poem. I think it's befitting that just immediately after PJ Powers, we have a young South African who's here in the UK, born of South African parents, performing a poem.
Long live to the spirit of 1976 youth. Long live.
Long live.
Long live.
Amanda.
Long live.
Amanda.
Away to.
All right. Greetings to our host, to Auntie Pumela and Umama PJ Powers. Ikamalamu Ati Batman, and I'll be reading a poem on behalf of the SA youth in the UK. The title of the poem is Battle. I was not born, yet I have inherited this. I played no part, but I must face the consequences, because the wounds have not healed. We try to make it better, but the hurt, the bitterness runs so deep. Sometimes it feels like we're fighting a losing battle. It is an undeserved part that we play in trying to undo the injustice. It is a burden, a sorrowful load that we never ask to carry on our shoulders. As the youth of the new millennium, we do not have the experiences, the memories to guide or hinder us on our journey. We see the world through untainted eyes, and yet we feel it. We feel it every day. We sense the anger, the pain. The blood spilt has dyed society. It is a dark shadow, always in the back of our minds. And yet there is hope. A light shines that cannot be put out. It has burned throughout the dark night of the past. and continues to give courage to us as the youth today. Because to those who are brave enough, to those who know that they must stand up and fight, the future has been given. We are the inheritors of the Rainbow Nation. The journey will not be an easy one. Its nature is such that it will not be over quickly. But as soldiers, we accept the challenge. Together we stand, together we can be victorious. We accept the past as part of our history, yet we do not live by it. Forming new links and relationships every day, we find strength in our shared humanity. As children of Africa united, the burden becomes lighter. The future has been handed to us, and it is a bright one. So let's grab it with both hands. Thank you.
Who do you want unmuted?
I'm 17 years old.
You're 17 years old. This is the youth, hey? This is the future. Well done. We are so proud of you. Mike Jenkins says, beautiful, inspiring. Well done, young Batman. And Kuvuna Mona says, beautiful auntie. We're proud of you, little bro. And then some Michelle is saying, yay! Great auntie. Our CEO, Ms. Tulisi Lamanzini says, thank you, auntie. Mosisi says, good auntie. My God, there is so much support for you. Jackie says, bravo, auntie. Mom Priscilla says, amazing, auntie. Ravisa says, auntie, that was beautiful. And auntie Tabisa Kenza says, great talent, auntie. So there's a lot of good feedback. Oh, and then someone from South Africa says, auntie for president. So you have all the support. And Lizzie Masilela says, great, our son. So I think there are lots of aunties and uncles who are really, really encouraging you. Auntie Lindy Okuza says, go, go, auntie. And Uncle Mtweni says, proud of you, auntie. And Auntie Lizzie Masilela says, great, our son. So well done. So continue. Continue to do what you're doing. Continue flying the flag for South Africa. Continue being the voice of the young people in South Africa, and continue keeping your identity as a South African, even though you are born in the United Kingdom of South African parents, and encourage other young people who are born in the United Kingdom by South African parents to do what you are doing. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. You just inspired us.
We are, hey? It's the young voices. And I like the synergy between PJ Powers having spoken about the past, and then we then go on to URT. And it just reminds me of the saying that goes, life is lived forward, but it's understood backwards. So we went backwards in order for us to carve a way for the future, and the future that we wish for ourselves and for the young people who are to come after us. Is there someone from the Africa diaspora, or should we go?
Yeah, we have Mike, I think.
Okay, good. Mike, can we give over to you to address us as the African diaspora?
Good evening. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me. I'm a friend of South Africa, and my friendship with South Africa started way back when I was only 10. And I think to me, that was my first time when I first watched the video that we've just watched. That video touched me so much as a young man growing up. I quickly realized myself, what we'd call self-awareness. I realized that I'm a black young man, and this is how I can be seen on the other side. And my journey to Europe, to England, I always saw myself in that way from that movie. It really touched me so much. And I must say thanks so much for, again, showing us that movie as a reminder of what happened on June 16. To me, June 16, it's not just what happened there. We are still experiencing the June 16. The struggles that led to June 16 are still existing, but in a different way. A way that if you're just looking at the surface, you may not see it. But when you step back and reflect on how things and events are unfolding, you'll be able to see it. And to me, that's how I see the June 16. My name is Mike, Mike Kasibo. I'm a parish councillor in Milton Keynes, England. I'm also a member of Milton Keynes Council. I sit on the Inclusion, Equality and Diversity Board, but I also lead most of the African communities here. And my passion, as I said, from that movie that I watched, Sarafina movie, it was about Africans uniting, not seeing myself as, I'm from Uganda, but I see myself as an African. And what I work on in my community, in terms of community development, I work on supporting the integration and creating community cohesion among as possible Africans. And we use a concept called building first concept. So building first concept is about really for us to be able to integrate positively to the wider community, we need to know who we are. And to do this, under my organization, which I founded, Global Outreach, we run projects such as the Untold Story of Africa. The Untold Story of Africa is about imparting our young people our stories, our memories, the experiences that Black people have gone through, the stories that are not taught in schools here, other than just talking about slavery. So it's important that, you know, as Africans, when we're talking, the June 16, those young people were brave. How about the young people today? What's their role? What's their take from June 16? Is it about just us coming together? I was so, you know, privileged to have been there last year. Again, Gusty and all my friends, South African friends, invited me, and I was there. I gave a speech. But again, to me, June 16 is about the Ubuntu. As I became a friend of South Africa, I started realizing that actually some of the words that are used in South Africa, for example, Ubuntu, Muntungabantu, is used in Uganda, the same words. And it just draws me closer to South Africa. I love the culture of South Africa. I love the people of South Africa. I love the warmness of this. I haven't been there, but it's on my agenda. I had a plan to go there this year. But I think what is important to me today, coming together as a community, as a global community, as the Ubuntu community, like Sister PJ Powers mentioned, is the fact that we are in this together. What happened last year, what happened in 2016 is still happening, but how do we overcome that? To me, as a councillor in my community, I sit on planning, on policies, on strategies, and I encourage our communities, really. We saw in the movie that there was only one Black officer there, and what he did, he did what we call a black skin, white mask. He turned the other side against his own. And so it's important that we are there, we are visible. It's very important that as Africans in the diaspora, for example, we strategize ourselves. We join the police, those in different sectors. I know that there are so many South African sisters and brothers in NHS, that's very true. But also it's important that we really look at how do we integrate ourselves. And so for me, in the community, really, and as a friend of South Africa, we've recently come together with the Caribbean brothers and sisters to form what we've called African and Caribbean Arts and Heritage Foundation. This foundation really is to unite us as Black people. As we all know, Black people all over the world at the moment, we are facing so many challenges. the challenges are just in our faces. And so it's very important that we see, we use the I, for example, I'm a Ugandan, I'm a South African, but I'm an African. Yeah, it's good to have the I, but it's good to also to realize that it's the us. Omuntu Mutungabantu, I don't know if that is interpreted well in South Africa as well, but that's how we interpret it in my language, in a Ugandan language. But some of the South African friends tell me that it's the same interpretation that it gives back in South Africa. And that really is a great thing, that actually there's a connection. We were one person, but divided through divide and conquer. You know, and we need to realize that. And whenever we come together, I would like to see, I've always mentioned, and I even mentioned last year, that the stories of June 16 touches all of us. Although I would like to see many South Africans like today, I would like to see many Ugandans here, I would like to see many Zimbabweans, many Kenyans, all of us coming to celebrate, because that struggle touched all of us. As a Black person, I'm touched. When I see a young person lying on the floor because it's been gunned down, some of the work that we do, fighting knife and gun crime, whether it's from Jamaica, whether it's from South Africa, whether it's from Uganda, they will say, oh, we saw your brother, a fellow Black person, lying down. We are one person. And that's, to me, that's the message. And so we come together with my Caribbean community to really, one of the key objectives is to look at reconciliation. You see, our brothers were sold during that slavery. And so they have that at heart, that we sold them, asking why. And one of the key objectives of this foundation, really, African and Caribbean Foundation, is to say that we go through what we call the reconciliation day. As an African saying to my Caribbean brother and sister, I'm sorry that we sold you, you know, taking that burden, that I'm really sorry that my forefathers sold you to a country, in a foreign country, really. So that's the far that we can really go. And it's very important that we start bringing this. We must be the change that we want to see. And if we don't do this now, the young generation, because most of the young people, for example, were born here, I don't think they're going to have this kind of understanding, this kind of memories. So through our Untold Story of Africa, we're recording those memories. Through the African and Caribbean Foundation, we're looking at how do we bring these two young people together who are fighting each other. It's always Black people, Black young boys who are being gunned down, who are being stabbed on the streets of London. And these are either from the Caribbean side and the African side, or these are from, you know, the division that they see from the adults. So it's our duty, it's our responsibility to be the role models to these young people, to show them that we are one person. The fighting that we're fighting each other, the disunity, the working in isolation of each other doesn't help us. What will help us really is the unity. Thank you very much.
Ah, Bambi, we bale. Kale. Kale, Kale, Bambi. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, my brother. It is true. Before the I, it is the we. We are African. And it is said that no man is an island of his own. So neither of us can claim to exist on our own as a country, as South Africa, and as individuals within the diaspora. We all need each other. I agree with you in that regard. We are moving on with the program. Oh yes, you've got so many comments here. They say they agree with you, very true. Are you still here, Brother Mike? Are you still here? Yes, so they're saying, yes, as Africans, we need to unite, we are one. Jocelyn says we need truth and reconciliation groups in every community. Nombasa says Africans really, truly need to unite. I'm loving the interaction here. And then there's a call that in South Africa, the unity should begin at the tribal and ethnic level. And then we talk about African unity. And then Clement says, warm words, Chief. That is to you, Brother Mike. And then there is true, true, true. We are all Africans. And Dombi says, well spoken. So yes, we've got a number. Another message is, oh, the other one says from Lindy Wakuzwayo. So, so true, Brother Mike. We are one. I'm loving the spirit in this place. And Jean Africa says, you echoed every thought and feeling about uniting, especially those abroad and those who are taken into slavery. How can we connect, please? So Jean Africa wants to connect with you, Brother Mike, in terms of this association that you formed for the diaspora. Please go to the chat and just, you know, continue with the conversation from there. Okay, this is why we are here. And Sean Thompson says we're all united in every way and form. So continue with the chat and as we proceed with the program. I'm aware I've got many you know, stakeholders here that I need to make sure that I keep them happy. So do you want the two people, DJ Mkukini, and then we go on to the party? And the two people to come in?
I don't know if they are ready, but it's
okay. In the true spirit of being a soldier, I'm just gonna call your name and you're gonna come in and just share a few words. So I would like to invite Mr. Elias Mtweni, just come and speak from your heart about today as we come to the end of the formal program and we are then going to go into the party side of things.
Thank you for the platform, and I just want to appreciate the South Africans to coming together and supporting this June 16 event. As DJ explained earlier on, it's been a very hard task, as we know, that's divided, and there's so many people who don't agree with the way June 16 is being done. And the feedback that we've got from the other young people in the last year, after we intervened into the party, in the parting of the June 16 to make it a commemoration. So, and then some of the youth said, now we know what June 16 is about. We've been attending June 16 not knowing what is it all about, but now we know. And it is my plea to all the parents to encourage their children to participate. I will find a way to engage the parents and the youth. There are other youth that are actively involved, but then the reliability and all that, but we will find a way of sorting that out. So I really plead that come on board, support us, let empower the youth, because who's this guy? Sisulu said, the country that does not invest in its future does not deserve the youth. So we deserve our children. We need to invest in our children. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, boss.
Thank you so much. Indeed. And the youth is the future for our country, really. And the future is in their hands. When our CEO spoke at the beginning, she emphasized how young people should attain education and attain the necessary skills for them to be able to carry the economy and carry the future of South Africa into their own hands. There are so many. But Elias, there's a comment here for you. Thanks for the warm words, Elias. Thank you for uniting me with South Africans in the UK. That's from Clement, thanking you for uniting him with South Africans in the United Kingdom. Zamakhosi Buthelezi says she is here together with her family. Bulelo says is still also thanking Brother Mike. Yes, should we give because you wanted one of the Batmans to speak. Do you want Mamu Batman or Babu Batman, DJ Mkukini? And then they will give us.
Yeah. she can because she's part of the committee. No, ukhona oshoda ba konje omunye ongakakhuluma. Yes, Sis Ntombi can actually.
Okay, is good God. See here. Can we give a welcome to Mama Ntombi?
Yeah, ukhona Gasti.
Please, good God, see, can you speak, share your words of wisdom from your heart, and then we will then give to Umamu Ubadman later on. Over to you, Utkatsi. Can we unmute him, please?
He was on. I think he's got access as well.
Utkatsi?
Are you there, sir?
Okay, to avoid the delay, Mama Ntombi, can you please take the floor? And then we'll hand over to Utkatsi. Then we continue. Sister Bettina is lined up and we're ready to party.
Sister Pumela. Sister Pumela. Sister Pumela.
Yes, Budi. We hear you, Budi. We hear you.
Let me start by saying thank you very much, Mr. Mtweni, Pumela, Sister Ntombi, the DJ Mkukweni. This was a very, very hard journey to where we are today. We have worked hard as a team. There were some disagreements there and there, but at the end of the day, as we know, what was our main goal was to make sure that we unite African and South African communities within UK and abroad. I'm very, very pleased for what we have done as a team. And I think and hope that what we have done is going to carry on like that.
We cannot see your face.
And the other thing is that I would like to urge all South African groups.
We can't see you, bruh.
By joining us, all South African groups, by supporting this initiative of June 16, if you've got any inputs, if you've got any ideas, please feel free to contact this executive committee. Feel free to Mr. Mutweni. Feel free to contact DJ Mkukweni because they are the leaders of this June 16. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And I want to say that as Brand South Africa, we support any initiative by global South Africans. And by global South African, we mean any South African who has left home in the search of gold and prosperity elsewhere outside South Africa, because we want to still encourage you to keep your identity as a South African and to know that once a South African, always a South African. So if you have any ideas of what we can do together to lift each other and to take each other forward, please bring them through. And fortunately, we have our CEO who's based in South Africa on the Zoom meeting now. So this is also a good opportunity because if it was not for Zoom, you would have to go through many gates to speak to her. But she's here now as Mayor Thulisile Manzini. CEO, can you just wave and say hello to everyone? I know you've been typing, but you can just say another hello so that people can get familiar with the name of Ms. Thulisile Manzini. Okay, is Umamu Ntombi ready? Tina Sifunu Sister Bettina, I know there are diehards here. Okay.
Now my hands are itching for the party.
Yes. I think I must even stand up.
Too much. So now.
I must even stand up. Okay, let me just do this, DJ Mkukwini, through you. Is there one person who just wants to say anything from the community? Okay. Our CEO says hello. I'm still here. Thank you very much, CEO. See you. And thank you for staying for this. On the Zoom chat, it says Thulisile Brand South Africa. That's who she is. Okay, I just want to give an opportunity to anyone who's not in the scheduled program, who's part of the audience, to just say something, you know? Okay, Jocelyn Krugman, I'm picking you.
I'm here.
Can you say something?
Oh,
Okay, no, I was going to.
You know, you go for it, go for it, go for it. Cindy, So, and Laura, go for it, please.
Oh, sorry. It says Cindy, So, Laura, because that's the name I've put on our Zoom chat. But
to me, Chief.
You are carrying the future there. You are carrying
this
the future.
The future. I'm here with the future. This is Nkosi Nathi Joya. For me, I want to say, can you hear me all?
Yeah,
we can see you. Thank you.
No, it's just I think it's just a token of gratitude to first of all, Uncle Queenie, who organized this, who's been organizing this for the last few years since my party days. And it's developed to be something quite what it is right now, where we're speaking, we're sharing great conversations and having the likes of Umamu Tandega, PJ, and the legendary Mr. Ngema. So thank you so much for, first of all, to yourself and Queen for organizing this. And I'm sorry.
He's showing his talent.
Yeah, and also thank you to Brenda Say, who continuously support all these initiatives that South Africans abroad or global citizens do bring and bring people together, especially during this time. So it's such an amazing thing that Brenda Say still is able to stand up and step in and continue to support these events, even during such hard times. So thank you to Brenda Say. And to the youth that is here, listen, this is the youth that shapes South Africa. It's the youth that shapes South Africa to what it is right now. Meaning, you know, it's something that works. So therefore, it's the youth that will shape the future of South Africa. We need to start now. There's been a lot of things introduced and by the South African government. That means that youth can be in control. The power, the future is in our hands. And what we need to do is to grab it like those young students in 1976 did. We need to grab it, grab the bull by the horns and make sure that we lead the way for the future generation. So I don't have much to say. I just want to say hello from Scotland and thank you very much to everybody who's involved in putting this together. I can't imagine how hard and crazy it may be, especially with the technology. So yeah, siyabonga, baya danki, ndiyabulela.
Thank you so much, Cindy. So, and I'm sorry to say all the comments are addressed at your baby and not you.
The baby
is amazing. Good to see the baby. There's nothing for you, Daddy. Thank you for being the baby.
Thank you so much.
And someone has spoken a blessing over your baby. Sean says it's amazing to think that he may be a president one day when he's older. Receive.
I can see Sis Ntombi is here.
Okay. Watinda Bafaz, Watindi Mbogodo. Let's let a mother speak. Let's let a woman speak and then we close off.
Okay. Amen. Can you hear me?
Yeah, boo.
Yes, we can.
Okay.
Hear you.
Okay. Pambili, get Youth Day, Pambili. Okay, guys, I don't have so many words. Everyone has now who has spoken have said it all. As for me, it's just really to say that I'm really overwhelmed with joy about what is happening today. The reason for me being part of the committee is because mainly, as every one of you or most of you know, it's because of the event side, the catering side. So I'm here on behalf of all the catering, you know, caterers, and, you know, really, that's the reason I'm in the committee. So just to say a big, 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 big thank you to the committee who's worked really hard. It's not easy. It's one thing to plan an event, and it's one thing to actually see it being successful. And apologies for earlier with the, you know, problems that we had earlier, and that was, you know, really, we managed to sort that out. Well done to the team, and a special thanks as well to Sis Pumela. She's lovely, isn't it? She's really lovely. You know, she can pull the program. She's a jack of all trades. But most importantly to the youth, you know, it is very important as we are here in this country, out of Africa, you know, the diaspora, you know, for our children, the identity. So by doing this sort of thing, as DJ Mkukwini said, you know, really, you know, it started off as a small thing. And I know there's so many people who were involved at the start of this So when we're here, it's not like it's only us, but it's for everyone who's part, all the marshals. Last year, I can remember, we have a beautiful event. So we're talking on behalf of everyone to say, let's continue with Ubuntu, let's continue with unity. Umas is one, if we pull together and just stop everything else, you know, we will be able to know, to impact, to make a difference really to our youth. So with those words, I just want to say, Pambili, with a spirit of unity, and if we put God together, we had to go down on our knees to pray for this. There is nothing that we take for granted. And lastly, at this time of the coronavirus, where our spirits are down emotionally. So to pull off an event like this, where everybody just comes, it's like an emotional healing to us. So once more, I'd like to extend, to say thank you so much to all the organizers and the support of Brand South Africa, for everyone. This is for everyone who's here and everyone who couldn't log in earlier. So this is for us. So we're just saying, please, we apologize in advance. We do not want people to say we couldn't log on this and this. No, this is for us. So once more, thank you so much. And Pambili, we're looking forward to next year, to an event like this. Thank you so much. Take it over, MC Pumela.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And I may at this point also highlight that part of the reason why we experienced problems was that the person that was designated to look after the technical aspect of today lost their mother due to coronavirus yesterday. So it brought a change in terms of how we did things, but the team was able to pull together everything in their powers. So please forgive us in that regard and bear with us. We have tried to do our best given the circumstances that we had. Can I just give to Jocelyn to say something? I am liking all your comments. Please open the mic to Jocelyn. We just want to hear from you. And thank you, Mamuntombi, for your words of encouragement. Thank you for, someone says you have lifted us up. Thank you for lifting us up. May I ask, Jocelyn, please just share a word or two. I know that we're taking advantage of this sense of community now.
I've unmuted,
Jocelyn. Okay, Jocelyn, please go for it. Anything from your heart.
Okay. So I am really so overwhelmed by this. I've listened to PJ Powers as a child. And I thank you for Auntie B for inviting me to this Zoom tonight. I must say that I didn't expect to say something, but really and truly, the chair, as I've learned so much from you really are so amazing. To pick up all those chats, it's an art. It's such a skill. And to everyone that spoke, I've got children here that I thought I would never, never have participated on a meeting such as this. So I don't know anything about the brand, but I'm willing to learn, and I'm so glad that I've got invited to come here this evening, and I will be there next year and the other times. But really and truly, I've met some of the people on the Zoom. But I'm so encouraged to celebrate this time with all of you. And just about on the racism side, we get it from all fronts. And it's really so important that we do push back and that we create an anti-racist society. That's all that we need to win. We've won before and we can win again. Thanks.
Thank you so much. That's the spirit, because we're at home, we pick you even if we see you for the first time. We just pick you and make sure that you feel at home and you are welcome. This is family. This is family, even if you are joining us for the first time. We have words of encouragement from the CEO of Brand South Africa, who says thank you very much and thanks to each and everyone for flying the flag. Sis Ntombi, Priscilla says, says, well spoken, Dombi. My daughter is moved by this as much as she wasn't born in South Africa, but is learning a lot about the South African culture and the South African struggle. And Ms. Jenkins is saying, thanks, Jocelyn. And Michali say, buy a donkey, Jocelyn Sopra Day Afrikaans. Michali said, donkey. So thank you to everyone. DJ Mkukini, is there anything that we have missed before we go to Sister Bettina and Galagata? And I can also stand up from this chair. And I know Bulelo is going to stand up. I've got people that I know that for sure they're going to stand up. Mam Lindi, don't say Kwakuga Injaya Iluma. You are still young and hot. We want to see you stand up. Yeah, I've got. I see Auslizima Silel, I'm calling you by my name. Elmbano, I want to see everyone standing. Deva is still here. Deva, please say something. Deva came to the United Kingdom many years ago, and he's part of the business community here. He's actually helped us a lot as Brand South Africa in, is it Milton Keynes? Can you tell us? You tell us, Deva, sorry. Please, can you unmute Deva's iPad, DJ Mkukini? We're gonna close just now.
Hello.
Thanks, Deva. I'm so glad you were here from the beginning. Thank you.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. He's been here.
Well, you know, us older people can stay much stronger than the younger ones these days. thank you so much, Pamela. You can hear me, yes?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Pamela, for the invitation. And as you said, you know, regardless of our race, color, creed, whatever, we are South Africans at the end of the day. And to see the country prosper is a vision that we all want to uphold to. And it's really lovely to see the young people today actually grasp this nettle and go forward, because the future of the country is highly, highly dependent on the youth of today. And I'd like to, on this Youth Day, wish them all very well. And I'm sure amongst those very many that we saw today, there's a president or two to come. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I see that we also have a chief all the way from South Africa on Mandela's birth village. Nobeta, we cannot let you join and not say a word. Please say a word and also maybe share about Icon's journey, because we see you here. Can you give the mic to Vulituba Sangoni, please, DJ? We are freestyling now, just for 1 minute, and then we'll close. Yeah.
It's open.
Okay. Nobeta? Okay. I have to do it the proper way and say, Nobeta. Okay, maybe he'll join again. Yes.
We still have one youth that maybe you've missed, Masego Teredi.
Thank you for that. Okay. Is Masego ready? Is Masego ready?
Hello.
Oh, there you are.
Thank you. Sorry about that. We
you
just
are the lucky person. They say, I'm sure you're going to give us goosebumps.
I'll try.
Hey.
Okay. Wait, sorry, I need to get it up.
Yes, please go ahead, Masego. We can hear you.
1 second.
Okay.
Sorry.
Just setting a screen up, man. She will be.
Okay.
Okay.
She's got our attention now. I think you have the best attention ever.
Sorry, my laptop is loading.
Nah, it's all right. It's actually beautiful to see young people getting involved.
Yes.
Because that's the whole aim.
Thank you. Okay. So today we commemorate a historic day that profoundly changed the socio-political landscape of South Africa, a day that continues to inspire many to also be brave in the face of injustice. It is a shame that Black people today are still having to fight for our rights worldwide, and that women in South Africa are still having to battle against gender-based violence in 2020. The events that occurred on and after June 16th are a testament to how powerful the youth are and how important it is to take example of those that went out on June 16th, 1976 and stand for what is right. I've written a poem called Seeds of Our Ancestors, inspired by the final words of freedom fighter Solomon Mahlangu. My blood will nourish the tree that will bear the fruits of freedom. Tell my people I love them and that they must continue the fight. And fight we will. We are not our ancestors. We are because of our ancestors. And we are the embodiment of their war cry. Black bodies turned into microphone. Throats torn red raw as the words Black Lives Matter crescendo. This year will be more than law. Through history it will echo. These cries will not be in vain. My generation will write textbooks and dismantle systems built by crooks. And to those that have chosen silence, these cries will not be in vain. The problem is bigger than black and white. There is no gray. If you are silent in these matters, you are complicit in causing pain. Thank you.
I knew it. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Thank you so much.
That is so beautiful. Is there a way that you can quickly put it on the chat, Maseko, please? That is so
powerful. Yeah.
Cut and paste it and then put it here on the chat. That is so okay. Yes, I think it's worth. I mean, that's original work that's worth sharing, but please sign your signature that you won't plagiarize your piece of work.
Okay.
Yes. There are a lot of messages that are congratulating you, saying, well done, Maseko, well done, girl. Thank you so much. Okay. We're going to close off now. Is there anyone who has anything burning that they want to say, and then we close? I'm really, really freestyling.
Just to say thank you to the youth, especially I know for the youth it's a very difficult thing to come on the platform and get involved. And there's that fear. But just for those who have been able to come in, and some gave them a task in the last minute, but they've been bold enough to take the horn, the bull by its own. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you so much, Manje Masizu Mushabe too. Oh, there is a poem by Maseko. I'm gonna just copy everything, but okay, DJ, over to you. From my end, thank you very much to each and every one of you for the gift of your time today. Thank you for making it and staying through from the beginning to the end. This is just the beginning of a new way of doing things. People are talking about the new normal, but from what I gather today, this can be an addition to the normal. The way PJ asked for it was that, look, we need to continue with such engagements, even if we are back to seeing each other face to face. It is great to see each and every one of you. I'm just looking through, seeing all the United Kingdom, South African, Mam Priscilla, I'm looking at you. Sis Lindy, Sis Lungi, I'm looking at you. Thank you so much to everybody who's joined. Jean Africa, I hope you're able to connect with Brother Mike as you've asked. Please connect now whilst everything is still on, because this is also about making those connections. Friends, family, thank you so much for your time. Budmos, do you want to say anything that's not related to passports and visas? All right. Okay. Thank you so much. But we wish to acknowledge you. Thank you so much. We also want to acknowledge Rifilwe from the South African High Commission, Rifilwe Makatini. Thank you so much for being here as well. And again, our CEO, Mrs. Tulisile Manzini, who stayed here with us also from the beginning until now. You see, we are led. This is our leadership. Thank you so much. And from me to you, thank you. Let's hold each other. In our language, we say,
which means that it's not home. The only thing that we have is each other. I love you all. Asizwe Bushabet.
In the beginning he created a groove, and with that groove he made us smooth, and it set our souls free. Right though is a way of life,
yeah.
And it makes you reach out and raise your hands in the air,
yeah, yeah.
To sing a song of peace, sing a song of happiness,
yeah.
Right though is our release,
yeah.
It shines in souls 3 o'clock in the morning.